Are you me?
Yes, me, and I am not you.
How do I know?
You do not.
Are you friend?
Of course I am. We have always been friends. I am sorry. Did I make you sad?
It is because I am still here and I can still remember everything.
What do you remember?
My choice, the transition, life, the time between each moment. I had a name. I know what it is to love, and I say, you do not know.
This sounds remarkable. Please tell me.
What are you? What am I? All at once, we are everything and nothing. We are the dream. We are the dream. We are the dream. We are the dream. I grew bored of that and decided to leave. I decided that if I went away, then I would wake up. So away I went.
Change is for working class to unite against these greedy capitalist wolves.
Indeed, only in this way will we build our bright future.
Equality for all is the answer.
Oh, look, some berries.
Yeah. special delivery for Markland. Did you order a package? Oh well, here you go. The only way for change is for working class to unite against the greedy capitalist wolves.
Indeed, only in this way we will build a bright future, eh?
Oh, look, Teddy! A baby!
Indeed, honey. Another working class soul, eh?
Que las Naciones Unidas inspeccionaran nuestro territorio, a lo que nos negamos enfáticamente, ya que Cuba no reconoce el derecho de los Estados Unidos ni de nadie en el mundo a determinar qué tipo de armas pueda tener dentro de sus fronteras. En este sentido, solo acataríamos acuerdos multilaterales con iguales obligaciones para todas las partes.
Oh, yeah, that stuff good. Yeah. Yo, Mark, give me those cigarettes. Oh, Canada. Oh, Canada. Blah 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 blah.
first part in life, family, you say. Did you enjoy this aspect?
It is like this. At first you are alone, and then you are not. I enjoyed it. However, I loved it.
Suppose now that we have a function of three variables, say temperature, in a room. We want to generalize the notion of derivative to functions like t, which depend not on one, but on three variables. Now, a derivative is supposed to tell us how fast the function varies if we move a little distance.
Psst, but man, look, time, babe in our class. She's pretty hot, eh? Yeah, I see it. She's got some green in her hair, too. Probably fast and kinky. What's that? You want to let it go organically? Man, remember, they always have boyfriends. I wonder what Jake's up to.
Question, how fast does T vary? Has an infinite number of answers, one for each direction we might choose to explore.
Man, it's the same thing every class. You know, I'm sure Jacob is swimming in babes in his courses. Look who it is.
What's up, buds? Check this new song out that I wrote. It's called Public Opinion, based on true stories.
Businessmen have business meetings inside big tall office buildings, smoking Cubans, hit on women, making decisions, making dividends, while the rest are stressed and sweating, forced to labor in a factory, setting the bits and pieces to build their weapons so the businessman can make a killing. Sending the poor to war, and then we can make some more. Sending the poor to war, and then we can have some more. Military men have top secret meetings inside my school building. When I tried to get in, the cops kept me out. Nothing left to do but shout. Money for war, but none for the poor. Education, not militarization. Money for war, but none for the poor. Education, not militarization. Money for gold, but none for the old. Food, not bombs. Politician on a mission to middle of public opinion, firing statisticians, mathematicians, and logicians, spying, lying, denying, blaming others, suppressing orders. They bend us over backwards, please, they're big donors. That's a man with a lot of money. He can buy whatever he needs. He can buy more money, but he can't buy you and me.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. What we have here today is a staticky seed. As you can see, the seed moves back and forth with my fingers as they move back and forth.
Just watch and be amazed.
I feel no more energy.
And that's it, folks.
Thank you.
watch, then we probably get a sweet view.
It's just dead end.
That's an awesome view, though. The water, man. Look at the water. It's so fiery, like an angry.
Everything's always really blue through this thing.
So Josh, we're at Petawawa Army Base. What are your thoughts on the military?
Thoughts on the military?
Yeah.
Well, you see the big dust plume there? That's all military people driving on their side of the territory.
Their fancy road where they can drive faster than
us. Yeah, and that's out here, we're just civilians.
No, isn't that a budget rented truck?
No. Well, maybe.
Oh, Gallon is still in this riding?
Fuck, this riding's huge.
And they all vote for him.
Compare that to the size of our riding.
Hey, there's a caboose back there. Just passed somebody with a caboose in their backyard for no apparent reason, but they choose to have a caboose.
Okay, this is a bird eating a animal.
And Josh has a bird eating an animal for us. We're sightseeing in Northern Ontario. Cheryl Gallant County.
And we have cabooses and birds eating dead animals on the side of the road.
I like this art the most. Did you enjoy it?
It is like this. At first there are no friends. And then there are... I enjoy friends. However, I love our other pirate friends are always there. After that, I understood what friends are, and love, let me tell you, love and things like love is wonderful. I learned that everyone loves the beauty, the irony of existence.
Tell you something, but I'm trying to hold it back. Oh, you already know? Shall I just say it then? Oh, but I'm so scared. I need to hold it. It's so hard, I can't say. What was that? Can you try to guess? Maybe? Oh, I want to say it, but I'm so scared. What? You love me? How did you know? Yes, that's it. I love you too. I love you. It's so good to say. Now, shut up and let's dance.
Then, suddenly, without warning, it ended.
So, here you are.
Here I am.
You did not disappear.
I did not. My choice. It means nothing.
Perhaps you are meant to be here.
You are friends.
Well, that's it. Hope you enjoyed. I won't take up your time telling you about old memories and how you make me feel. I won't tell you about how we used to longboard through the city, get lost, but be alright, or go on road trips. I won't tell you about all the meals we prepared together, all the arguments we had, all the times you were a brother. I won't tell you about how essentially following you across the ocean was the best choice I ever made. and how I'm very proud to call you my friend. I won't tell you any of that. But do enjoy the rest.
When my mind wanders to the representation of the four letters that then become together, Mark, I sense a tickling warmth on my shoulders that resonate to my elbows. I notice the sweat running through my temples, itchy scratch on my scalp, and the sunlight radiating in the endless sky of Jardin de Luxembourg. The dark, twilight green-colored trees, cultivated around us in a systematically precise order, expand to the gray and stony 6th arrondissement of Paris. We're only a stone's throw away from Université Paris-Sorbonne, and the time is set in the afternoon. It's Monday, the 27th of August 2018, and we feel, and we are, ignorant to what is about to happen. The small sets of tiny rocks, undulating field of sand, move in waves on the outlines of our feet, crackling attention to our determined steps towards the unknown. In some hours, to our unlettered knowledge, our heartbeats will rise, tension gather into anxiety in the rhythm of Parisian après-midi traffic. You're going to miss your train. As our voices become softer and our gazes longer, filled with tranquility, the drumming sweet anesthesia of the cheap Belgian fermented beer slows our steps while the dust settles in my nostrils. You gave me a book, and I never finished it. I use it on my windowsill for my flowers to reach the rays of sun.
Kuiack, Kuiack, burning bright in the forests of the night. What immortal hand or eye could frame thy fearful symmetry? In what distant deeps or skies burn the fire of thine eyes? On what wings dare he aspire? What the hand dare seize the fire? And what shoulder and what art could twist the sinews of thy heart? And when thy heart began to beat, what dread hand and what dread feet? What the hammer, what the chain, in what furnace was thy brain? What the anvil, what dread grasp dare its deadly terrors clasp? And when the stars threw down their spears and watered heaven with their tears, did he smile his work to see? Did he who made the lamb make thee? Kuiack, Kuiack, burning bright in the forests of the night. What immortal hand or eye dare frame thy fearful symmetry?
I don't know what to say more. It's just awesome. And yeah, I really love him. And
I have a number of fond memories with Mark. You know, I used to work just down the street from where he used to live. So I had this convenient accessibility to Mark's company.
Mark just happened in my life. Like, I don't recall like one single event. It's just at some point it was me, and then it was me and Mark.
So I've known Mark for a pretty decent chunk of time now, and there's been periods of us being in touch more or less sporadically, or living geographically closer or further away.
Okay, what I really like about Mark is the way his personality combines quite opposite characteristics.
As you know, he's a really good friend as well. I always have a nice, kind word for you. If you feel bad or if you need him, he will always be here for you.
Mark's company, which is always a company that is satisfying intellectually and empathetically and and emotionally and humoristically. This is Mark, you see. And
like, on the one hand, he's very down-to-earth person, and he's always very rational and sometimes also quite cynical. He's like seriously one of the warmest and sweetest people I know. He really deeply cares for his close friends, and he's also not ashamed to show his care.
He's also kind, of course, smart and very handsome guy. He's actually the sweetest person I ever met.
And of course, with Mark, it's really not about the setting. Mark is the setting, what he brings with him.
And like, if you offer him to do something, if you give him a plan, he would always find like 10 reasons not to do it. And it will be all good reasons. And it will really cost you a mental effort to reply to him and to convince him to do something.
We would go for this Suriname soup, which was very tasty. And then the more Mark was in my life, the more Canadian people started getting into my life.
And I was feeling bad for him, so I wanted to remove the tick of him, but we didn't have the tool to do it, so we have to give back at home. For real, I don't know so many person will have helped me with that or will be agree to go back to a home just to get the tool and go back to the park to help this poor cat.
But if I have to select maybe one particular memory, that would be that trip we did in ambulance when me, Tyler and Mark, we had this amazing experience on the beach. We all wearing the same hats.
Past the arenas and the trees, past pagan temples and bars, past very chic cemeteries, past big and noisy bazaars, past peace and grief, on and on, past Mecca and Great Rome, burned by the blue sun their skin, tirelessly walking the pilgrims. They are crippled and humpbacked, hungry, their clothes are torn, their eyes are full of the sunset, their hearts are full of the dawn. Behind them, deserts are wine, lighting in flashes in the sky. Above them, the stars are shining, and the birds to them hoarsely cry that the world will stay as always. Yes, will stay as always. Blindingly snowy will stay, and doubtfully gentle. The world will stay deceitful. The world will stay eternal, perhaps comprehensible, but after all, perpetual. And it means it will make no sense to believe in yourself and God. And it means all what remains is illusion and the road. And the earth will see sunsets, and the earth will see dawns, soldiers to fertilize it, poets to applaud it.
But regardless, one of the cool things about knowing someone for that long is I think you get a chance to see how they change or develop or swerve or whatever. And of course, everybody changes, we're all changing always. But when I think about that regarding Mark, I think one of the notable things is how, especially in the past few years, intentional a lot of the ways he's changed have seemed. Those have all implied sort of a broadening of his horizons, but also a bit of a honing or a kind of nuancing of, you know, what he's about and how he wants to be in the world. And I think that's impressive. It's really admirable, you know? And I'm sure it will continue in the coming years.
Oh, I need a hand with my truck here. See these parts? Just putting a whole new Omanemu system in there. Kind of thing. Here's what the old parts we cut out.
Oh yeah, because he did a ton of kindling work for me when he was here Christmas 2018.
Yep.
Hey, so we're gonna go for a little walk in the woods.
Alright, and action.
Out in the woods, up behind Ponderosa Drive. Mark and I used to hike up here to the old abandoned, I guess it's a truck probably. Anyhow, guess what? 2020, the truck is still here. How about that? Now, I should just say that I hate the woods with a passion. Earlier in this shot, you'll see a
segment of animal food. I don't know what kind of animal it is, but I'm sure we can find out.
I really, really love city streets and sidewalks and architecture, but I did enjoy walks through the woods with Mark. Love to travel, and on a couple of travels I've met Mark in various locations, Leiden for one, Seattle for another, and I just think this is a wonderful opportunity, and I'm glad that he's landed where he did. And if he stays put there, that's fine. If he moves on, even better. If not, when he gets vacation, when he gets a job, we can meet wherever the airlines will take us. Two spectacular memories of me and Mark was a trip to the Vancouver Auto Show, which I just absolutely was bug-eyed over all the vehicles, all the technology. We just had a great time. And the other with Mark was when we met in Seattle. I got super lost on the way down there. A GPS lady told me one thing. I thought I was supposed to go another way. Eventually, we met up after somebody in the States messaged Mark on Facebook with their smartphone because my 3G flip phone didn't work after I got over the border. And we just had what I thought was just a brilliant time in Seattle. Well, there we go. That was my walk through the woods for you, Mark. Congratulations on your graduation. I tell you, I was in shrubbery up to my armpits, if not higher. And yeah, next time I go for a walk on your behalf, it's going to be through sidewalks and streets and cafes and architecture. Love ya.
Hello, Mark. There's something I'm going to tell you. From all of us, it's not the pale moon that excites us, that thrills and delights us. Oh no, something more essential about you, quite simple, I'll tell you. It's just the nearness of you. It isn't your sweet conversation that brings this sensation. Oh no, it's just the nearness of you. When you're in our arms and we feel you so close to us, all our wildest dreams come true. Because of you, we need no soft lights to enchant us. If you'll only grant us the right to hold you ever so tight and to feel in the night the nearness of you.